Welcome to Late Night Chat with JT and Nico, episode 9.
You underestimated greatly. Most number ones ever. How long did it really take me? The part I love most, they need me more than they hate me. So they never take shots. I got everybody on safety. I can load every gun with bullets that fire backwards. Probably wouldn't lose a single rapper. Niggas make threats, can't hear them over the laughter. That's cause I'm headed to the bank, nigga. Sinatra lifestyle, I'm just being frank with ya. I mean, where you think she at when she ain't with ya?
All right, welcome everybody.
Welcome back. If you're still here. Because we are.
Yeah, sorry if the intro was too long for some of you listeners out there with that minute lead-in that we've usually put in at the start. But listen,
you know what?
At this point, if you don't fucking like it, too bad.
That's it. Turn it off.
You know what? No, though, and I know we usually open every episode like this, Jay, kind of giving some podcast updates and things that have been going on. You can get into your piece here in a minute because I know you got some things to say about all that. But quite frankly, at this point, you know, I do appreciate all the feedback we've gotten so far. But at some point, we're just going to have to do things the way we want to do them. You know what I mean? So,
exactly.
Keep it coming. Like, if you guys got your opinions and things that you want us to improve on, this and that.
So, always.
But like,
always appreciate it.
The thing I'm disappointed about is last episode in particular was one of our lower listened to episodes so far. I don't know if the picture of the Momo scared all you guys off so far or something like that.
I heard our previous guest was scared a little bit.
Right.
But it's okay.
But I just feel that like we're on chicken top of shit. Our game for that last episode. Like we've now entered an area of comfortability on mic. You
exactly.
And me.
We're actually getting here and we can sit and talk and, you know, just freely and talk and enjoy
right.
our conversation. It's just joyous sitting down and shooting the shit with, you know, anybody who wants to listen, like we said.
Right, and I get it. Guests spike the listens up because people want to hear other guests, other, you know, us interact with people, friends of friends, and you know, all that. I get it. But yeah, I mean, if you happen to listen to this one, you haven't had a chance to go back and listen to the other one.
Yeah,
hopefully soon, like I said, our whole library will be up for you to take a listen. Just because, you know, the sound was on point.
On it.
Yeah, we talked about some important things, like it wasn't all jokes, fun and games and shit. Like, we actually had some good conversations, I think, on the last episode.
Yeah,
so,
it got interesting.
Yeah, so I just wanted to kind of shout that out and kind of say, you know, at some point, we're going to find what we kind of are looking for, and I think we're getting to that point now, like, with this show. So,
kind of like a good guideline and good sort of, you know, flow to everything. That's what we're trying to get to, you know, just like a late night chat, man. That's what it's supposed to be.
Yeah. So
in the morning.
And I think we're entering that space, the kind of what we you know, started out looking
that's
for
what
when we started this.
Yeah,
so
that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah. So that's what I mean. So I hope you've been enjoying yourself so far. If you stuck with us this long, you know, continue to listen because this is going to get better and better. More things are coming, right?
Exactly.
I just want to kind of give a shout out to everybody again. You know, we
for
open
listening
up this way usually every time, but at the same time,
it might have been me too. I didn't get to post probably the same way that I was able to last time.
Sure.
Because, you know, we're like some people have been slacking, but you know, like you said, we can get to that.
Yeah.
Right. But I mean,
yeah.
It's okay. It's been a busy couple weeks for everybody, for us. And so it's hard to fit everything in. So hopefully after this week, we can get everything back on track, get everything set up straight. And
especially me, as Jay is alluding to over
Nico,
here.
Right?
Not so.
You know why? Like, you know, I he puts a lot of time and effort into it, but he's got a busy schedule, so it's hard. I'm not trying to make him feel like shit. He's not slacking in any means, though. He's just been really busy, man. I mean, I don't understand how he's still standing and he's still awake. He's still awake looking at me.
I got a drink right here beside me, Jay.
I'm wide awake, man. I got coffee here with me, and he's drinking alcohol. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, if he passes out over here, I'm just going to leave him and we'll film it and maybe put it on
the
podcast.
That'll be a late night chat.
But no.
Late night nap.
No, yeah, late night nap, eh? But no, I'm not about the slack. It was just, like I said, this one here, there wasn't much editing we had to do the last one, so it was pretty good. It was pretty easy for him, and so he was...
Yeah, but don't worry. We're going to keep...
Keep it
know,
going, man.
Keep
we got,
doing it.
We got some shit that we take care of, and then we take care of you guys.
Yeah.
No homo.
quick shout out to Crazy Candy Ladies, somebody we wanted to kind of mention. Not an official sponsor in the show of the show yet, but absolutely someone that
you
should
check
out. You
might have seen it on my storyline or something. I've tried to repost some of their stuff and join their group. So if you want to check it out, Crazy Candy Ladies.
Yeah, if you follow either of us on Facebook or Instagram, you might see that we're trying to repost some information about this new venture. And I don't think the website has gone live as of yet. Might have to check my stats on that. But they're getting ready for Easter right now. They've been posting a lot of these Easter kind of candy baskets.
Yeah, so I would think they're getting pretty busy.
Yeah, if you search on Facebook, the group has been popping lately. Like, there's been a lot of posts. There's been a lot of activity going on. They just gave away. They just did a giveaway. I think they just gave away a prize the other day. I saw on Facebook. And the pictures they're posting are really nice, man.
Yeah, it's like, nice little baskets. And it looks like you can get just about whatever you want and set up for just about anything you want.
Yeah, I tried one out. I mean, like, yeah, in all honesty, like I said, like, we did mention the previous episode, like, we know the people that are running this, but you know, do yourself a favor and check it out. You know, don't let our word kind of speak to
it. No, not at all, because they're actually doing, you know, enjoying themselves doing it too. And, the more people that get into it and enjoy it with them, you know, start purchasing, start buying things, you know, the better they can get with their advertising and their websites, exactly. And the bigger they can go,
and I
think
they would also appreciate your feedback right now. So definitely check out the product and let them know.
What you think.
Right along here, though.
Nico, why don't you let everybody know about your birthday? Because it was Nico's birthday a couple of days ago.
Yeah,
we post on a different basis, so by the time you get it, it might be a little bit behind, but
yeah, it's gonna be probably just over a week by the time this gets posted from my birthday. But yeah, I turned 32.
Oh man, you're getting old, eh, bro? That's why you didn't want to do anything, eh? You know,
I didn't want to do too much. Christine, no,
I was saying Nico's getting a little old there because he doesn't want to do anything. A dinner and a movie. That's people my age do that shit.
Yeah, right? That's pretty much what we did. Yeah, I kind of just told the girlfriend that's all I was looking forward to. We went out for dinner, and which was a lot of fun. And then we went to see Captain Marvel, which I'll talk about here in a little bit. That was pretty good. I enjoyed it. So I went out for some drinks before and after too. So no, it was a good time. But yeah, no, I just didn't want to. I've been so busy as of lately, so yeah, I guess I'm getting old. I'm just kind of content with what I got, man. I'm happy, you know. So I was kind of
like, enjoy the time with the girlfriend, and you know, do what you have to do and enjoy yourself, because you've been busy. So like I said, you've been so busy lately. It's it's good to, you know, enjoy and just take some relaxation time, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And try to get some of the stress off.
That's what it was,
you know.
Right?
Except when, you know, for up to the point when you lose your phone. You know, so let everybody know about that one.
Yeah. So
here we go.
The week before, probably just prior to this show, the last show getting posted. That was actually half the reason why the show got posted late.
Yeah, exactly. Because unfortunately, I only have a friggin' cell phone, so he has to send me everything on through his cell phone instead of through the computer. But
I was off the grid, Jay. I wasn't getting your usual 1,000 texts. You know, you checking in every second to make sure I'm alive.
My 1,000 texts. So you guys have girl groups. What are you talking about? WhatsApps.
Yeah, we have group chats. That's right. Exactly. Friends do these kind of things, Jay.
Yeah, exactly. They text people. Exactly. You dumbass.
I think it's funny, though, like the social norms that are so, for most people to you, are odd behavior, like video game playing.
You're just saying that I don't like... what do you call it? I'm texting too much. It's just like you guys in the group, back and forth. I have a BBM group with
the guys.
Bro,
if you don't hear from me in a day, you send out like an Ember Alert, bro. Like,
there was another one.
No joke. Today. There was another one today.
Seriously. I haven't gotten a thing back saying anything was all right, but
not
apparently
yet. I think
Christine
she's still missing.
But she said she might have seen something on the news about it. But
yeah, let's not get into that.
No,
though,
but
anyways.
that was just
hopefully by
one.
The time this gets posted, that has been
resolved.
Figured out.
Yeah,
yeah.
And safely.
But yeah, so coming home one night, I happened to be drunk. I don't know if that has anything to do with it. I'm gonna say it doesn't.
Maybe. But yeah.
I seen some old friends. Peter was there.
Mm-hmm.
And I took an Uber back. Yeah, it was a really bad ice storm that night. And I got out the Uber. And then all of a sudden, I noticed that my phone was gone. So like, I went to check for it. It must have been either in my lap or I went to take it out of my pocket and it fell somewhere. Yeah. It must have fell in there's huge puddles all over the place, right? Outside of the car when I got out, inside in front of my building here. From the Uber, and and just all of a sudden I'm patting myself down like a crazy person.
Yeah.
I go turn around to the Uber. I say, I can't find my phone. I look inside the Uber, can't find anywhere in the Uber.
Yeah.
Go upstairs. I'm like, okay, I don't know where the hell what happened to it. I go to get my girlfriend's phone to call it.
Yeah.
Next thing you know,
somebody picks up.
Some bum picks up.
Nice.
Homeless guy, as he identified himself as. But of course, as Jay knows, my phone which is kind of this blessing in disguise. You could barely hear me on my phone.
Exactly. So you're always texting
me. Right. So you couldn't even hear the person barely on the other line. all we basically heard was the guy said, I'm a homeless guy. He obviously must have walked by and saw the phone like I dropped probably when I jumped out of the Uber.
That's what happens.
Picked it up.
Yeah.
You can still answer a phone call from an iPhone without unlocking it. You can receive a call.
Because it'll still open. It's the same with mine.
Yeah. So that's what happened. So he's like, hey, listen, you know, give me some money. He's basically holding my phone for ransom.
Ransom.
And, you know, he's like, meet me at the McDonald's. There's a McDonald's by me. So we're like, okay.
Yeah.
All right, so let's
you must have dropped it out. You must have dropped it when you got out of the car.
Yeah, that's absolutely what happened.
But I think that's what I did with my remote there.
Your
street tends to suck up things, man. Yeah. I don't know what
That's what I mean. That night in particular, too, it was a nice storm. So, like, it was raining hard.
Yeah, yeah.
So it was really shitty out to begin with. I'm a little drunk. I obviously must have just dropped out of my hands my lap or somewhere, right? So anyways... So I go there fucking like 2 a.m. in the morning. This is when the hour jumped forward that day, too.
Oh, so okay. So yeah, it sounds like 3 a.m.
Yeah, so it's, yeah. Well, I think it was almost 3 a.m., but it was technically, like, I guess, like before 2 a.m., but it jumped forward already at this point in the time. So yeah, it's like 2:30, I think, by the time we got to McDonald's. Go to 2:30 a.m. crack McDonald's, right? It's known for crackheads being there at that time.
That is the worst McDonald's. It's known for crackheads, not even just at 2 in the
morning. Robberies, all kinds of shit.
8 o'clock in the afternoon.
So I'm standing around there.
Yep.
You know, we said, hey, listen, this is what we're wearing. Meet us, because my girlfriend picked up because we called the phone from her phone.
Yeah.
Guy never shows, or at least didn't make himself known that he was sitting in there.
For sure.
Maybe because, you know what I mean? He didn't expect a couple of us to come because he only talked to her.
He was going to just see some chick there.
Maybe, yeah, and take advantage of the money situation. He basically said, well, I'm not giving you money. We'll buy you a meal or something like that.
Yeah.
But we were kind of just like, okay, whatever. Just meet us. We'll see what's up. Because at first he wasn't asking for that much. Like 20, 30 bucks or some shit.
Exactly. 20 bucks.
Again, I can barely fucking hear the guy.
20 bucks will get you a nice rock in the city.
So,
I don't know that.
Yeah, I was about to say, I don't know personally, but okay. We're standing there.
Yeah.
We call the phone. Phone's off.
Yeah.
So, all right. Fuck it. I just left.
You know what?
I'm like, enough of this shit. I waited for like 20 minutes.
Sold it for 25 bucks.
Waited for like 25 minutes. I was like, no, that's enough of this. So I just called Rogers right away. Canceled the phone.
Yeah.
Anyways, got a new phone now.
No, it works out.
But I was off the grid for a while. Which
how does that feel?
It was nice, man, actually. Not looking down constantly at your phone.
You had a tablet with you when I seen you, or you had
I had my iPad, because it has iMessage on it.
Yeah, so you had something. You weren't really completely off the grid, dude.
It was really just for, like, my girlfriend to reach me and whatever, right?
Yeah,
But I wasn't... Not everybody has an Apple product, I couldn't actually text most people I know, right?
Yeah.
So it was off the grid for the most part, like, honestly.
Poor you.
Yeah. You know, it was hard, bro. I remember back in the day when we didn't have cell phones.
There's some people that can't do that. There's some people that can't put their phones down for 2 seconds.
It was nice, but that's the thing. Even me, like, I look at my phone if I have it in my hand quite a bit.
Yeah.
Surfing the net, whatever, just checking shit.
I've been trying to get off and not do it right as much, but now, you know, trying to put the podcast on and stuff like that, I got to get on there still, but I try to stay off it as much as I can, man, because it drives you fucking nuts.
It was nice. It was a nice break. That's all I got to say about that.
True,
it was
man.
Nice.
Getting off of social media, they're fucked. They have so much bullshit happening around them. They have so much, you know, everything's so intertwined. You see the crap that people just want to post. They just want to, you know, nothing's real like this. Nothing's just shooting the shit.
Because everyone's kind of trying to show us their life the way they kind of want you to see it, right?
There was that sick thing that happened, unfortunately, in New Zealand, man. And I don't want to give it any real time, but social media they're still trying to get stuff of that off of there, right? Which is sad.
Yeah.
You know? So, I mean, once it's on there, it's on there, man.
Yeah.
That's why I get off. I can't stay on it all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, I gotta get off it once in a while. Like you said, it was nice to be off for a while.
It was, yeah. It was, you know, I didn't have a phone for a few days before I got my new one, and it just felt good, you know what I mean? Like having to constantly check in with things or like just be on my phone doing nothing.
But now you got a phone that actually you can hear out of.
Yeah, now I do.
Sorry, you can speak into.
Yes, now I do.
I can hear you speak.
Yeah.
So that's going to be weird for you, right? You're going to start calling now. And really.
No. I'm still not picking up the phone, bro. Anybody who knows me knows I don't like talking on the phone. Yeah. Honestly, it had nothing to do with my phone being broken. It really was just a coincidence.
You're
that
just a texter. You're just a Tommy. What do you call it? Tommy Texter?
Tommy Texter, yeah.
Yeah, I know.
But birthday was good.
Yeah.
Lost my phone before the birthday. That wasn't good, but I'm back on. So keeping busy, though. Yeah, that's it's not a bad thing.
Trying to, right? At least we got some time. We made some time to get together, right? That's the best part about it.
Yeah, this right here. Yeah, catching up with everyone. So that's good. Moving along here. you like that? I said that just for you, Jay.
That was a way back for me.
Anyway, it's time to check our stats a little bit.
Check your stats back.
Checking our stats, a little update for you guys for some of our topics that we discussed last episode. Some things that happened in the world since we last talked about them.
Yeah.
One being, we talked about, for a good half hour, I think we conversated about Momo last episode and the Momo challenge and the reemergence of that whole thing.
Yeah. That's it was a little crazy. I still haven't got to actually see the video, but I'm kind of, whatever. I'm not into it. I'm just kind of passed by me right now. I still have it, but that's another thing. You can't really find it anywhere.
There has been some reemergence of some stuff on YouTube now. Oh, yeah? You're right. I think they've gotten rid of the actual videos where she's popping up, but now, since it's been some time since it originally happened,
it's still there.
People are re-uploading videos now that show what happened now again. Yeah,
exactly.
Because you can't stop it.
No,
right?
It's on there, it's on there, right?
Yeah. I guess they'll remove it as fast as they upload it, but
that's the thing. Is once it's on somebody's computer, man, that's it. You can just
it's there.
Yeah, once it's on your computer, you just keep putting it back up if you wanted to, right? If you had it on your computer, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But, yeah.
So basically, you're
saying the creator.
Yeah, so just to touch on that, after we talked about it, the Momo creator basically made a public statement by saying that...
it wasn't him. I mean, it wasn't...
Well, yeah, I mean, he's already kind of cleared that up. This is a year ago when
just,
it first emerged,
Yeah, it was
emerged,
basically
right?
just a piece of artwork.
But he tried to say that Momo was, dead now. Yeah. He tried to make a public statement to kind of help... I guess the kids, and probably to protect his ass somewhat, that were affected by this whole thing.
Exactly.
Basically, it is kind of a weird-looking
fucking statue.
He said the sculpture doesn't exist anymore. It was never meant to last.
Yeah.
It was rotten, and I threw it away. Who knows if that's actually fucking true or not? I don't think it actually is.
In his garage. I can see it sitting in his garage. It's going to collect dust for years and years, and one day it's going to reemerge. And it's going to be in some fucking movie. The Momo movie.
You know what? I wouldn't be surprised at this point if they made a movie about this.
They'll have
to
make some movie of something,
he had stated that that was the case. And another thing I actually just learned, and I'm just reading right now, actually we're talking about this, is that he confirmed that he was inspired by the Japanese legend of Ubume, U-B-U-M-E, I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, a woman who dies in childbirth and returns in changed form to haunt the living. That's what he was inspired by to fucking create.
With fucking
create
bird legs?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, maybe that's what the thing looks like.
I don't know.
A woman who dies in childbirth and returns in... Oh, wow. So
there's even a weird filter on one of the things like Snapchat, I think it was, that had googly eyes like that. It was just kind of
that was there before, I've heard.
It was,
that was just a coincidence that
it
kind of looked like that now.
It's
just
throws everybody up, right? You can just fuck with them.
He basically said he threw it away.
Yeah.
It was never meant to last. So whether it's true or not, I mean, the fact that he said that, I mean, it's good because he kind of maybe put it to rest a little bit. I think he's basically
maybe
trying to separate
show
himself.
That to the kids, too, that have seen it and see that it's been gone and he's gotten rid of it. But, as long as it doesn't pop up. But like you said, it's going to be, we're both saying, it's going to be out there regardless, one way or another. It's going to come back out. If I wanted to watch it tomorrow, I probably could. Mm. Right? And that's the thing. Is that if it the only thing is they can keep it off now they can start keeping it off the channels and off the kids things, right?
Hopefully we can move on and people just forget about this thing, right?
Yeah,
but I don't think we're going to see the last of it, to be honest with you.
No, it'll come back.
If Packers are having a fun time with this fucked up shit, then they're just going to continue.
You're getting
doing
views,
it, right?
You're getting all that kind of stuff, so they're probably making money off of that.
I wouldn't be surprised. Halloween rolls around, you're going to see Momos walking around and shit like that. Yeah, bro. I mean, it's
that'd be hilarious.
Looking thing, right?
Well, are they going to ban it? Like, do you want it to ban the clown costumes and stuff?
That was fucked up, what was going on with those clowns. You remember that? Yeah. But that's what I mean. The clown fights. If they don't know about this, like, there was people getting actually beat the shit out of them because they were just standing in schoolyards dressed as clowns. And it wasn't even Halloween. Like, it was, like, in October. Like, at the start of October, people were just, like, there's clown sightings all over the fucking city.
It was for the movie, wasn't it? Wasn't it for it?
That was going on, I think, at the time, but that wasn't for that. No, it was just a phenomenon weird, right? That was starting, and people, like, there was videos of people getting their ass fucking kicked because of that shit, though,
because
right?
People,
like,
get scared of clowns, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is.
Not only that, though, these guys were standing legit spots, some of these guys, with, like, knives and stuff, and just trying to scare
them. Being creepers, yeah.
Yeah, they were creepers, but in the dark, there was people, like, just, like, creeping up to people. Jay's being unprofessional and fucking keeping his phone on.
Right. No, that's my, you know, like we talked about last week, another, like, checking the stats with my epilepsy. I do got to take medicine, and sometimes I forget, and the alarm has to go off.
Sure.
It really fucks me up. No, it does, man. Unfortunately, right?
Anyways. But,
go on.
Yeah, no, it was some fucked up shit, that clown stuff. I almost forgot about that.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, they were popping up everywhere. It was, what do they call those? They're like sort of like challenges of some sort, no? Wouldn't you think?
Like flash mobs and shit like that.
Where they just do things like these guys.
Yeah, like challenges.
These guys are wearing their masks.
Planking was
a
thing for a while back. Yeah, things like that. I know, like phenomenons.
Things like that they do, right? But who knows?
Anyways, the creator of the statue is also quoted in saying he intended the character to be scary, but never intended it should be used to hurt anyone. It is a ghoul about the death of a woman in childbirth. In a way, its reason for being is to scare children, but it wasn't supposed to be used in the way that it was. He said it was never meant to be used to make children harm themselves or cause any physical harm.
So he's basically trying to distance
himself as much as possible from this shit right now, right? I mean, he probably feels really fucking bad that this happened.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, what can he do, right? He made a fucking scary creation. But you know, someone took it and ran with it, right?
It's not his fault, bro. He made a creation. People take a picture of it. That's what they do nowadays. You know, they cut people's heads off and put them on other people's bodies, you know? You know what I mean? Like...
You're fucked, bro. What are you talking about, cutting people's heads off?
No, you know, like in the pictures and stuff like that, like, you know, like somebody was complaining about when we first posted.
Check your stats.
You getting it now? Now I'm really checking stats. So check your stats
on that. He talked about it on the cast.
But that's what I mean. They can take a picture of anything and they can do anything with it, right? They can put it on, you know, and this is just proof that they can put it into the video. They can make it part of somebody's life, everyday life.
Yeah.
And it's not, you know.
We have no control over these things.
Technology
right?
nowadays, man. And it's what it is, right? That's all you can do, really. You could just sit there and try to hope that your kids don't see it or people don't get affected by it, right?
Yeah.
But there's not much you can do. It's the way the world's going. It's life, buddy. It's the way it is with the computers nowadays and internet and stuff like that.
Yeah, no, it's true. We have no control on the information that's put out there.
Like we can check everything right now just at one click of a button, right?
Yeah.
As we're doing this, let's say as we're talking, we can always just double check stuff, and you know?
Yeah.
That's how quick it is, you know?
Another thing to follow up on from last episode, we talked about the True Detective season 3.
Yeah. Remember we were saying that we didn't like it so much, and then all of a sudden that popped up not too long. Like
we had talked about season 2 being the weakest out of all three of the seasons that aired, and then Jay kind of forwarded me an article that he had kind of seen on the net, if you want to talk about it.
Yeah, just, you know what, he was a little disappointed on just the way the whole thing turned. I think Woody Harrelson, he said he was out of all three of the True Detectives, I think he was more disappointed out of that one. It didn't really have the same vibe as the first one with Matthew McConaughey and himself, and then the last one there with, and I can never remember his name, the black guy on the last True Detective. What's his name? I always forget it.
Mashallah Ali.
And then the one with Colin Farrell and...
Rachel McAdams and Vince Vaughn.
That one sucked. Like, I mean, it didn't suck. It was a different. It was a different atmosphere. They're in Los Angeles. It was a different sort of.
Yeah.
You know, it was a whole different sort of take on the whole. I don't know.
Yeah.
That wasn't as. What's the word I'm looking for? Maybe as into the whole genre of the whole True Detectives and the way that they're using
it. It was noirish, but it detectives. Wasn't, like, dark like the other ones. Like, yeah. You know how, like, the first one kind of had some paranormal
The first one was a little messed up.
Yeah.
Right? And that's because those guys are great actors. Yeah, they can pull it off, man. They messed up themselves.
Number two had some things I liked about it, but overall, it was definitely the weakest of the season. Anyway, so
he didn't want to do it on HBO. That was a big thing too.
Yeah,
right?
he wasn't even thinking of going on TV. Was quoted in saying when he was talking to somebody in regards to how much he enjoyed season three. He said, "I was not really wanting to do television. Well, it wasn't television; it was HBO. So I feel lucky about that. I was, you know, kind of disappointed that the second season wasn't as." And then he kind of trailed off, and he says, but now the third season, which I've only seen the first four episodes because I've been working, I'm really psyched about the third season. I like
he didn't want to diss the actors.
Yeah, you know he kind of got caught, you know, in one of those situations
He might need them in a film or a role or something like that that he's producing one day. Well, they asked him, too, if he was going to, you know, if he was going to have another appearance in one of the True
And he
Detectives.
Said he didn't see it happening, I don't think it should. I don't think it should.
Why?
Because their
story's
done, bro.
Their story is done. It's true. Yeah. Well, he can be one of he's a guy that can pull off another face. Do you get what I'm saying? Like,
sure.
Excuse me. He went from if you can go from Woody on Cheers, okay, from being a dumbass to going on. I think what was the other show he was on TV for a few episodes? Was it Will and Grace?
Did he star in that? I'm not sure.
Star, but I think he was a guest.
Yeah, sure, right? Sure. Recurring, like
Yeah, and for a few episodes, right? And then that was all he did for TV, and then he started getting into movies, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, when you can change the style of person you're, like, he blends in very easily as a second character, as a first-time character, like a lead character, as a supporting actor, you know what I mean? He can do them all. So, I mean, why not? You can put him in as a convenience store guy or something, dude.
Yeah, he was on Will and Grace. He was, I guess, with Grace for a while. I just looked it up.
Yeah,
my stats on that. Yeah,
but
you're right.
That was the thing. On TV, he could never be that type. If he was playing in a sitcom, he could never get out of that role as Woody.
I think his movies were much more in that tone of, like, different types of characters. He was really able to stretch his legs with that and actually show his acting chops. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And show who he was as an actor.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now as they all get older, they want to show who they are as producers and executive producers, stuff like that, right?
Well, yeah, because you slap your name on something, you're making money regardless, and you don't even have to be as involved, right?
Yeah,
just because of who you are and, like, what you're associated with. That's what showrunners do, right? These guys,
they have a good time with it.
What have you been checking out lately, Jay? Anything you want to kind of...
I've been watching a lot of Star Trek again.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know if you've had a chance to watch that. I mean, you've watched that. There's other ones.
Discovery, the new one?
The Discovery?
Yeah.
Apparently, I'm going to probably check out that new Love, Sex, and Robots. Is that what it's called?
Yeah. I've seen it on Netflix. I don't know. I have no idea what it's about.
They're 10-minute episodes.
Yeah.
Which is kind of weird, right? There's like 20 of them or maybe 15 of them.
Right.
But I have no idea what it's about either.
No, I just saw it.
You know what, 10-minute episodes is quick. You can sit there and watch it, no problem. But I've been into a lot of things. I'm still into Blacklist. I mean, I think I've brought it up to you before.
Yep. You've mentioned it here on the show.
Have I mentioned it on the show as well? But that show keeps going, and it's just now, you know, it's getting really good, and I don't know if it's at when it's going to end or if it's going to end. Mm. They're in, what, the sixth season now, so.
That's the James Spader show?
Yeah, it's really good, man. He's really good as an actor, and I don't know what it is. I just want to be Reddington, man. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Is he a bad guy on that show?
Yeah, he's bad guy slash good guy, but he's doing it all for himself, really, if you think about it. If you actually watch the show.
Is this the guy that controls the list?
It's more inside trading. Okay. Right? It's more like inside trading. It's more like,
Hitman type shit, right?
But it's more like inside trading. You tell he's feeding the FBI. He's like an informant, right? So he's feeding the FBI stuff. But
see, I don't really know what it's
he's
about.
He's getting the FBI to find these guys, and what he's doing is as they find them, he knows about what's going to happen. He just gets them to find them. He gets what he needs from them, and they arrest him. But the FBI doesn't know. They know, kind of, that he's getting what he needs.
They're working with him because he helps them, though. Yeah,
exactly, right? But, okay. I mean, it's been a great show. I mean, there's more to it now.
Uh-huh.
Like, there was a little spinoff of it called Blacklist Redemption. That was a good one, too, if you want to watch that. in the middle of it, but
it's already had a spinoff. The show, I didn't know that.
Had a spinoff in like the third season, right?
How many seasons has it been on the air at this point?
At this point,
yeah,
it's been like I said, six seasons. Oh, I think we're in the sixth season, maybe.
Yeah,
maybe
and it's
more.
On the air right now.
Yeah,
like, taking a break yet?
Okay. No, it's not. It's moved to Friday nights now. It used to
is
be
this
like
one of those
Sunday,
like
20 something
episodes, like a season.
Well, yeah, not so many, maybe. Yeah, but it is primetime television. So it's there are episodes. A few good ones on Global. I've been watching stuff like Resident, little things like little filler shows, Resident, Coroner. There's the Coroner is filmed here in Toronto, which has been really good.
Yeah, so NBC for the States it airs on, and here it's Global, City.
I think I see it on NBC, streaming. Yeah. Streaming is the way, guys. Streaming is the way. I don't care what anybody says.
Yeah.
Except, you know, you can't always watch everything you want to watch.
Yeah.
Right? So, you know, it is what it is, so... But what about you? Anything different to you? I haven't read anything, obviously, but, you know.
So I've actually been listening to a couple of podcasts lately. You know, I think it's worth mentioning because we're in the business of doing a podcast now, right? That, although we're not making money off of it. I mean, isn't necessarily business, but we do it, right?
I've been doing that, too, yeah.
And I know you listen to them, too.
Yeah, different
ones. Yeah, one in particular that I listen to now and then is the What the Fuck podcast with Mark Maron, comedian.
Okay.
And he's been doing it for quite a while now, and it's kind of like, at this point, that's like his bread and butter. Like, the podcast saved him. Like, you're talking about a miserable fucking guy, this Mark Maron guy, who his career didn't go the way that he had hoped.
Okay.
And he, you know... In terms of like his career had hit a wall until he started this podcast.
Yeah.
And the podcast really helped him out. He started interviewing comedians and actors. And I think he put out like two or three podcasts a week usually, you know, like an hour and a half interviews with people. And it's really good. It's one of those podcasts where people come on and they let loose and he kind of does the whole, you know, like, let's start at the start of your life, like where you grew up, this and that. And then they kind of get into these more serious, laid-back conversations. And you kind of... If the people that go on there are proper with it, like he even had Obama on, but of course Obama still kind of came with like a, you know, to act a certain way because he was still president at that.
Yeah.
Or actually when he was on the podcast, he may not have been president. No, I think he was still president when he was on the podcast, actually.
Yeah.
Anyways, so he's had some big people on the podcast, including all your favorite comedians. I mean, YouTube is stuff because now at this point, if you were to... look for his podcast. He has a service where he's had so many episodes. He has 1,000 episodes. This newest one I just listened to was episode 1,000.
Oh, great.
And that's why I want to talk about it.
Yeah.
Because he has such an extensive library of episodes now. He has a service where I think now you have to pay to listen to any of the old content. So when the podcast comes out, you have maybe about 3 months worth of stuff you can listen to.
Mm-hmm.
But then once, you know, this time goes on...
Yeah.
You know, the 3 months ago, that month now all of a sudden becomes like you have to have a paid subscription to listen to it. So if you don't listen to them as they come out, you basically have to end up, you know, unless you find it on YouTube, which is some guy that uploads them all there anyways.
Yeah.
So yeah, check it out. Extensive, really, really big library. I mean, anybody you can think of, he's probably interviewed them at this point. You know, it really, really good show. And just like, you know, like I said, like one of those more down to earth kind of conversation type shows, and you get to know a little.
So he interviews properly, I guess.
Yes, not unlike you. He doesn't do it just to cause controversy. Although he's had some controversial
episodes
because you know, he's had a Louis C.K. the comedian on. This is prior to all these allegations about him jerking off and all this kind of shit, right? Not allegations. True, he admitted to it. Yeah, these are not allegations. Sorry. I wish it wasn't true, but he's a sick individual, I guess, and
what's
in some
problem?
Regard. I still think he's funny.
People pull your anchor, but you can't do it in public.
I mean, he asked. I mean, he asked every incident, but it was because he did it from a position of power.
Get it. Of course.
Yeah. Anyways, not to get into that, but he was on the podcast, and they had a falling out, and then he invited him on the show, and they were friends for years and years prior to him coming on the show, so like... You witness, like, listening.
They have a history. And
yeah, listening to these two work things out on the air during the podcast. It was uncomfortable in the room at times, and you can just feel it. It was honestly if you want to listen to a good podcast done right, Jay, not this fucking Mickey Mouse shit every year, listen to that. Check it out. You just YouTube it. It's Louis C.K., Marc Maron episode. It is fucking great.
I got a few people I like to hash. Maybe that would, I'd have to learn how to figure that out.
Yeah. It was honestly.
I got some friends too that I need to hash some stuff out with too, right?
Yeah.
I got some friends. I got some, you know, family that I like to hold back a lot. And, you know, so maybe one day I'll have to listen. I'm going to have to check that out and just see how they do it.
Because he kind of used it as him being in show business, Louis being in show business, and as a way to bridge that gap and bring him on and actually be like, hey, man, like, well, you know, what the fuck happened? Like, you know, are we cool? Are we good? Like, you know what I mean? And, like, they hashed it out over the air.
Yeah, that sounds like a pretty cool thing.
Really fucking interesting show. And then, so I was listening to episode 1000, and they chronicle, like, from the start of the podcast, how they started out and how difficult it was and kind of like some of the trouble that they went through when they first started and you know, where his career was at that time and like all the great things that has come as a result of him doing the podcast. So it was just really nice to listen to. So even if you don't listen to the show and you're interested, check out episode 1000 of Marc Maron's What the Fuck podcast. It's just WTF with Marc Maron. And he talks about some interesting things.
Is there any like actual streaming platforms like any
It's on iTunes. You can go to the podcast app on iTunes. You can just Google it and listen it off his website. There's lots of he's on many streaming platforms. You don't even just have to have iTunes.
Like, because I use a lot of free ones and stuff like
wherever that. Wherever you look for your podcast, just search for it. It's one of the most popular podcasts out there right now.
Yeah, it probably does have it there. It's probably on TuneIn. I mean, I use TuneIn. I use them all, right? I mean, I've tried everything, right? SoundCloud doesn't have as much as it used to, right? But
I don't think he's on SoundCloud.
No,
but they have
you know, they have more music than anything nowadays, right? So I mean, I'm gonna have to check it out because
episode 1000. It was really good.
I've been listening to true crimes, about serial killers. And, you know, maybe I need to learn about, you know, spread it out a little bit, especially when it comes to podcasts. I mean, I listen to other ones, but nothing like that you're mentioning.
Well, now that we do one, I think it actually helps. I mean, not that you gotta listen to something and steal everything from them that they're doing, all their techniques, but there was a couple things he talked about that actually I wouldn't even mind incorporating, like things for this podcast, things I envisioned that he talked about kind of trying to start, like even just the cold intro to the show, like the way he does intros when he starts talking to people, is he just press record. And they start chatting. And all of a sudden, sometimes people don't even realize that they're on.
They're on.
So he kind of lulls them into a comfortable situation.
It's kind of like what happens with us in the beginning.
So instead, you don't just pause it like we sometimes do when we have to fuck up and try it five times. Like, oh, welcome to the show.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to go back and delete it. He just kind of presses record.
Yeah.
And the editor just fucking splices in right when the conversation at some point where it starts getting interesting. And then they just fucking off to the races. So I really liked that. And they talked they talk about the nitty gritty about making podcasts as well. And not only that, like just some of their stories and experiences. And then they go through all the listener questions, like a bunch of like dedicated listeners ask them questions.
Yeah, yeah.
And they just do Q&A for an hour, you know, like and it was really, really informative and interesting. So if you have any interest or if you listened to his show before or just really want to hear an interesting fucking 2-hour podcast about making podcasts and being in the business of that, listen to that. Marc Maron, What the Fuck Podcast, episode 1000. Yeah, that's what I've been listening to at least lately. That was really good.
Marc Maron.
And another one, if you are in the hobby that I enjoy comic collecting, a new comic podcast that started maybe a couple of months ago, and they do YouTube videos as well. They have the cross-platform thing going on with the videos and the podcast.
Check. Yeah. That's actually a cool platform.
Yeah.
How it works out.
It's called Cartoonist Kayfabe.
Yeah.
And kayfabe is like another term, like it's a wrestling term where, you know, it's basically them not breaking kayfabe, like not breaking the storyline going on, like the fake, you know, storyline that wrestlers put on for people. So keeping in that mode, you know what I mean? Like,
keeping it going.
Exactly. So, not breaking character, so to say.
Yeah.
But it's two creators that work in the business right now, kind of more indie cartoonist guys.
Okay.
But that are also fans of comics. So it's them just breaking down like their favorite comics, but they're also, they come from it from perspective, like these guys know a lot about comics, but listen, they also work in the business. So they're going to tell you a little about everything.
Yeah.
So like every episode,
every angle, just about.
Yeah. It's really, really fucking interesting. And the one guy that does it is, Ed Pisker is his name.
Okay.
And he did a comic that it was well known that he did a Hip Hop Family Tree, it was called.
Okay.
And I have all the books for that. There's about 4 volumes of
probably
it out. But it was of course, yeah, I have it. But it was a comic that was serialized online originally.
Okay.
For years. and he chronicles hip-hop from the start of hip-hop to, like, the early 1990s so far he's done. So, like, if you're into hip-hop, really, really cool. Like, I am, like, old school. Like, it's
so a you're talking, it's going from now to the... Down, back to the early 90s?
No, from the start of hip-hop he's made it up to, I think, the early 1990s, like N.W.A. and this kind of stuff. Like,
yeah, where it's starting to get different and really starting to change.
Yeah, so, like, he's a creator I really enjoy because he shares other interests of mine that I like, too. So, like, I had already checked out his comics that he did of the hip-hop family tree. So when him and the next guy, Jim Rugg, started this Cartoonist Kayfabe, I checked it out right away because I'm like, these guys are going to, it's going to be an interesting show. And it has been so far. And they've been growing a big following on YouTube. And so far, you can tell, like, just looking at
their channel. And yeah, I've never seen it because you do a lot of YouTube searching. It's a lot of streaming that way, so I don't get a chance to actually, you know, do it on I'm not always hooked up.
But that's the thing. I mean, the YouTube's good because you get to see the comics that they're talking about. They'll show them in the YouTube video. But if you just want to listen to the podcast, you have the raw audio as well, right? So, I mean, usually when I'm at work, I'll just throw that on the background.
On the podcast,
right?
That's what I got to do. I have to try that one because it's, you know, it sounds interesting. You got a few good ones there.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, I didn't know there was that many good, decent, half-decent podcasts out there. I know there's a bunch, but I try to find them, and I don't know what to look for or who to look for and stuff like that. I mean, it's all up until I started listening to you guys there.
Yeah.
I mean, it was all new. I was just trying to
figure out. There's all kinds of stuff there, man. That's the good thing, great thing about podcasts, is no matter what you're into, if you fucking got, like the smallest interest in something, there's a podcast out for it, man. Yeah. Like, you know, what, You like ping pong? There's a ping pong podcast.
I can imagine. No, I know what you're saying. You know what I mean? I know, like, I found certain things. Like, if I wanted to listen about somebody in general, right? Like, if I wanted to listen to something, I would type in their name and anyway, I could find it, right? But I'd like to talk about certain topics. Like, I don't know. I can't find one about just certain topics. I found one now, like I said, that I liked about the serial. After I watched the Ted Bundy tapes.
And they're not all going to be good.
No.
And a lot of them are just variety type shows where they bounce around like topics like we kind of do, or just talk kind of programs, which, you know, which is fine too. That's all good. But yeah, if there is certain interests that you have, I guarantee you there's a podcast out there for it, right? And and it's one of those things too, like, for instance, like, do you like the movie Goodfellas? Great, classic, right?
Yeah, obviously.
There was a podcast I listened to by these other guys that did another podcast, and that they went off and did a podcast called Goodfellas Minute. And there's a bunch of podcasts like this out there. They fucking do each episode, they analyze a minute of the film, and they literally the minute. They play the clip,
and then
they go into the minutia of that clip. Like, who is this in this scene? This is this guy in this scene.
And
like,
they
this
really
actor
crack it down, eh?
And they look, they check their stats, they get everything. They like, oh, so this actor showed up in this scene. Yeah, this guy was also in this movie and this movie, and they every fucking detail about that 1 minute at a time.
Just
so
the movie.
That's the whole movie. So say it's, I don't know, two hours. You fucking got 120 episodes of that fucking podcast. It was fantastic. I listened to the whole thing, bro. And like,
that's a weird style of doing something, right?
Like, yeah, I mean, they do it for Star Wars. There's one called Star Wars Minute. Any type of big, I'm sure there's a fucking Star Trek one where they do it, where they basically analyze and talk about, like, the people that are really into something,
It's like those things that they do for Walking Dead and stuff like that. They do those after
lots
shows,
of
right?
Yeah, The Talking Dead.
Talking Dead.
Yeah, like a wrap-up.
They do the wrap-up shows and stuff like that. And I don't know if they do them as much anymore. Mm-hmm. But I know they do them, right?
I don't know if they still do it because I haven't listened to it in a long time, but there's a podcast called How Did This Get Made?
Okay.
Where they talk about movies, like horrible fucking movies, and how they actually got made. Like, and like, you know what I mean? Like, and they actually sometimes get the people that worked on the movies in to conversate with them about how the movie, like how it made it to production, problems did they experience, why did this scene turn out so shit, like, you know what I mean? Like,
that's crazy. I don't know. Like, I know these guys that I listen to the true crimes and stuff. They read actual court things and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Anything that's said, any documents.
Oh,
sometimes they play tapes. Sometimes they play the tapes back, right?
Yeah.
And everything, right? But then they talk about, then they get their own opinion on it. And they talk about, you know, what they think about the person in the head. And you know what I mean? If the person's all right, you know, and they try to figure out the person. I don't know. I find it interesting. Like I said, I like to pick at people's heads, but you know, I like to get to know them, like pick at them and try to figure out what the fuck is wrong with them.
Mm.
But, you know, even though I can't figure out what the hell's wrong with me, but, yeah. Maybe now I'm starting to hang around you too much. Maybe that's what's wrong with me. But, no, the podcasting, I didn't even know, man.
Yeah, man.
It's better than actual books. I mean, I almost picked up a book of your story the other day, Tom Sawyer. I don't know why, man. Somebody told me I would like it one day.
Right.
Right? I said that I should have read it. I never read it when I was younger.
Listen,
right?
I mean, as always, I've been reading lots of comics, but I'm not going to get into that because no one cares to hear about that kind of shit.
No, but you know what? That's how people learn about different
sure.
podcasts.
And sometimes you know maybe
what?
I will.
I learned, but... I've heard of different podcasts while listening to that other one, right? That I tell you that I was just mentioning about the true
yep.
crimes. I've heard in other ones about,
yeah.
you know, and that's how you hear about,
sure.
you know, they spread the word around, right?
Yeah.
And it gets passed around. And,
yeah, that's why I kind of wanted, not that fucking Mark Maron needs me to fucking mention
no,
this podcast.
No, yeah, but you're just letting people know. And letting them know, man, because you know that I like listening to stuff.
I want our listeners to know that there's other good content
yeah,
out there.
Exactly.
And I'm also a fan of the medium, right?
Yeah, exactly.
In terms of what I've been watching, though, I just watched a great new show that just hit Netflix this past weekend. Fucking already watched the whole thing because it was, what was it, like 8-episode seasons, half-hour episodes?
Okay.
So you got a few hours in an afternoon, you can knock the whole thing out. That's kind of what I did, the lazy Sunday after my birthday there.
Yeah.
I watched the whole season. It's starring Idris Elba, you know, of The Wire and lots of other things. He was in the Dark Tower movie. He was in Star Trek. Lots of things. You've seen this guy in something. He
yeah.
was in the Ghost Rider movies.
Okay.
You know, anyways, Idris Elba, he is this DJ in it who's a washed-up DJ. I think he's in England, and he's English
yes.
in real life.
Yes, yes, I think I see
it. It's called Turn Up Charlie,
yeah.
the show.
Yeah.
And in real life, which I didn't know, I had to Google it after to see if there's going to be season two. I was interested
yeah.
to see. He used to be a DJ before he was an actor.
So it was real.
Well, that's the reason why he wanted to make the show, because it was one of those Netflix originals,
yeah.
right? And I always like these Netflix originals. You can find one with somebody you like. I find that they're passion projects always. Like, there's stuff that where if they have a big enough name and they want to go do a show with Netflix and they agree to it,
yeah.
it's something that they're actually interested in doing, not
yeah,
like
yeah.
something they're getting paid
no,
to do.
Exactly. And they're having fun doing it. And yeah, exactly. And it makes it actually for a better, whole better.
Right.
Episode of television, kind of television.
Yeah, so
yeah.
I read that Idris Elba was talking about the article I read. He pitched the show in the room and Netflix bought it on the spot. And he was like, listen, I know a thing or two about DJing. I used to be a DJ. I
yeah.
still do it on the side, outside of acting, you know, just for fun, like,
yeah.
because I enjoy it. And, you know, and so the show basically was about him being a washed-up DJ and his best friend from childhood coming back to England, moving back. And
okay.
meanwhile, he went off and became a big movie star. And the person that he's with now, his wife, but they're not married, who they have a kid with, is now a world star, like a DJ who like travels around the world and does big gigs, something that he would love to be in the position of doing. And their daughter is like a shithead, like because she's one of those kids who the parents are never around, so she does things for attention and she acts out.
Yeah.
So she meets the Idris Elba character, the Charlie.
Yeah.
And they bond, they have a relationship, they kind of like, you know, he likes the kid, he kind of took care of them, care for them one day when they had to go out somewhere.
Yeah.
And they turn around and like, listen, you know, I know you're not doing much because this guy, he's working like fucking weddings and like random gigs, right? So the friend feels bad for him. He's
yeah.
like, why don't you basically become the nanny? Like, you're going to be the nanny? Like, yeah, yeah, I'll give you money. You agree to watch her because you seem to get along. We need somebody to watch her because
yeah.
none of the other nannies are working out because, you know, she acts out. He reluctantly agrees to do it, but basically just to get closer to the wife and so he can work his way back into the DJ business because
right.
she has a studio in the house.
Yeah, exactly.
So he kind of starts working that relationship in order to get in good with them, and eventually, you know, I won't spoil it for everybody, but you see him kind of basically get kind of what he wants, but it kind of all goes to his head again, and you may see there was other problems involved as to why it didn't work out for him in the first place and why he is in the position that he is in now.
No, yeah.
So I won't get into everything,
okay.
but in the world of DJing with all the partying and this
yeah.
and that, you can imagine that there's other things kind of transpiring. Anyways, great, great fucking show. I really enjoyed it. It's really charming. The child actor was really good in it. Idris Elba was great in it. Funny, really interesting. Just a kind of lighthearted, kind of really good show. Like I said, 8 episodes, half hour each, so you're not going to be wasting a lot of time watching it.
There's a lot of new stuff coming up, like you were just saying, Netflix,
yeah.
right? And there's a lot of new stuff
yeah.
coming up on there, right? I mean, fun to watch and, you know, just
yeah.
new things all in general. Totally different storylines, totally different. I mean, there was one I was looking at watching Afterlife. It looked looks pretty good. Something about his
afterlife. It's
called his wife leaving him.
Oh yes, that's the new.
I think it's an English guy from the office. Right? Is English or British or it's
yes, Australian yes, that did look interesting. That, yeah. He looks like such an asshole.
No, it still looks hilarious, man. Like, he looks like a prick. Like he acts like such a prick in the whole
show. The usual character he plays.
He's really good, and I'll be honest with you. I've been wanting to watch it, but like I said, I've been watching everything else, and it's kind of. Everything's starting to slow down.
Yeah, the Ricky Gervais show. That's it, Ricky Gervais. I was trying to remember his name, yeah. I like his stuff.
Yeah,
some of his most recent stuff hasn't been great, but this does look good. That was the next one I was going to check out.
It looks interesting. I have it on my list of stuff to watch, right? And there's a few other ones that are coming up, and I can't remember them off the top of my head. There's a few new ones that, you know, after you tell Netflix to remind you, they only start popping back up once they're coming close, right? So I know there's a few things coming at the end of March that are interesting, right?
I just think Netflix has so many of these Netflix originals at this point, and they're not all great.
No.
But I don't want this one to kind of get buried. That's why I kind of want to let people know. Like, I don't think it will, because Idris Elba, I think, is a big enough name for people to check it out. But, you know, that might not even sound like everyone's cup of tea. Oh, this washed-up DJ, what the fuck is this, right? Yeah. But no, it was really good, bro. Definitely check it out, even you. Yeah. Like, it's called Turn Up Charlie.
Yeah, see, I read it. All I thought was with Jersey Shore, and that's all I thought, man.
Because the name Turn Up Charlie.
Well, yeah, it was just kind of like, you know, the whole DJ, I read the whole synopsis of it in the beginning, right?
And no, it's good.
Yeah, but I didn't think I was going to like it, right? So maybe I'll have to check it out, see what it's like.
Very quickly, the last thing I want to mention is the fact that I saw Captain Marvel.
Yeah, go ahead. Everybody's gone to see it, I think, this
weekend. Not going to do a deep dive into it. I will just say I enjoyed it. So when you match it up compared to all the other Marvel movies, it's definitely, I think, in terms of, like how good it was, like, in the lower tier of Marvel movies. Yeah. I still liked it. I still am a fan of the Marvel movies. It was good. I don't think it was bad. A lot of fucking controversy because of all these comic gators, all the people that are bashing it because it's a woman superhero.
Yeah,
right?
I thought, like, it was a guy. That's what I thought he was. He was a guy, Captain Marvel.
Captain Marvel originally was a guy. He was a Kree, the alien Marvel, Captain Marvel. But this is a character that exists in the comics too. It's not like they just fucking made her a woman, him a woman for this movie. No, this is also a character. She got the powers after he died in the comics. So, anyways. Not to get into the whole thing, like I said, I thought it was good, though.
Yeah?
Like I said, it wasn't in my top five or anything. I don't think it was the best. It was probably in the lower half of all Marvel movies for me. Yeah. But I've enjoyed all of them to some degree.
Of course.
So,
I think everybody out there has.
What's that?
I think everybody out there has to some degree.
They're all connected. But it was the only thing that kind of bugged me, I will say this about it, is that you can definitely see they were trying to push for it to become important in the grander scheme of things of all the Marvel movies. Like, they were pushing for some of the events to tie it together in this movie, where
you can kind of bring her into something else.
Yeah. So, you know, some of the choices they made I didn't love. Mm-hmm. But if you like Marvel, like cosmic stuff, like space stuff, there's some other characters that show up in this that you might notice from other Marvel properties. So that was pretty cool. Some alien species that are from the Marvel comics that showed up in this.
Oh, cool.
I did enjoy it. We had a good time watching it. And I think Brie Larson did a good job, I think.
Well, I mean, it was a big hit, right? Yeah. It just hit 600.
Oh, it's million. Killing. Yeah, 700 something worldwide. I think it was that was weekend? On the weekend.
Weekend, that's nuts, right?
700 million, fucking worldwide.
That's in a weekend, dude. And you actually have to go. It's not like something you could just.
That was first week, actually. That was first week.
People go still to the movies to watch this. You know what I mean? Regardless of how much you can stream of stuff, you know, people still go and pay. Like, I have a brother that goes and watches two or three times. He'll go and watch the DC or the Marvel movies. Anything that has to do with comics, if he likes it, he'll go watch it two and three times at the theater, which is kind of nuts. He'll watch it back to back, which I could never understand that.
Me never, yeah. Right? Never
but
done that.
He loves them, man. I don't know what it is. He also just celebrated his birthday, this thing, got himself a tattoo, you know. He had a big argument. He's turned 24 this year, got himself a nice Batman tattoo on the
His
leg, which turned out pretty good.
No, that's cool.
I think I'm the only one that doesn't have a tattoo. I was just telling you.
I don't have one either.
Yeah. I don't know.
I have nothing special I want to get, to be honest. Exactly. Yeah, I'm just not going to get one just to get one.
Yeah,
you know?
What's there that you're going to have on your body and you got to look at for the rest of your life? You know, there's a few things. I mean, there'll probably be a few things that come up, but still, man. When you're hairy like me, man, it doesn't work. That's the problem, man. It gets covered up.
Yeah.
Right? So, unless it glows in the dark. You know, that would be kind of cool. Anybody with the glow in the dark tattoo. That'd fuck everybody up.
So yeah, fuck the haters. Everyone hating on Captain Marvel just because she's a woman or yeah, because no, they, I didn't, you don't I didn't know that. Man, I really it was good, man.
Yeah. Yeah, see, and you know what? That's the thing too, is that people that don't know the actual comics is that they're gonna hate because they thought maybe it was a guy or whatever and stuff like
some
that.
Some people just don't like Brie Larson. Like, that's fine.
You know the storyline behind it. You've read the comics. You've read, people sure. are. This is where your judgment comes. Your judgment's coming from between you, the book, and the movie.
Yeah.
And you're comparing the two, and it's just like television. It's like Gotham or whatever. You can't compare that Batman to the Batman.
No.
That you read in your comics, right?
No.
There's
you got to separate yourself from.
Yeah,
it
I mean those yeah. directors and stuff. They all have their own opinion yeah. and their own view on it, right?
Yeah.
So I mean, you can only. They do it so many times throughout over the years,
yeah.
the same person, then they got to have their own views of it. You know how, you got to kind of take it for what it is. You can't base it. The comic book is the original, and that's it, man. That's the way I look at it. And if I haven't read the comic book, I can't really judge it that way.
Yeah.
Right? But I thought, I thought it was a guy. I didn't watch any of, I didn't see any of the commercials, to be honest. I don't think it was put out there as much as... As,
the trailers
the
actually
work.
Weren't that great, to be honest.
No, but I don't
with
think
you,
it was
yeah.
put out there as much as the other ones. Like, they're always showing Avengers, they're always right. showing other stuff, right? Like, they're always showing the rest of the
yeah.
the comic books and the Marvel characters.
Yeah.
They didn't show this one as much on the TV. I don't know, I didn't notice it.
There was also a lot of internet trolls that were really bashing the shit out of this movie before it even came out. That really just, like, the...
Well, they've seen a lot
like
of things.
There's a community of people called comic skaters, which are basically, like, you know, like... Yeah. These alt-right, like, fucking, like, you know, Trumpers of the comic community.
Oh,
they're
you
basically...
You must hate those guys, right?
What's that?
You must hate those guys.
Oh, yeah. Because these are guys that are, like, that don't believe in multicultural characters, new characters, women characters.
Is
they
that
hate
where
on
this whole gay,
for no
they had
reason.
A gay
very
superhero?
Ignorant.
They were talking about... I was reading something on Google about them having a gay superhero, and they were having an argument about that. And
Iceman?
Yeah, I don't know if it was Iceman or
Iceman
what.
Became gay all of a sudden in the comics a yeah. couple years ago, and
okay.
he was never a gay character.
Okay.
So that caused a lot of issues, but...
You got to remember when the comic was made.
Yeah.
Right? The time that it was made.
Yeah.
Right? You got to remember that, too. Were they allowed to put that
yeah.
kind of stuff in?
I just find the reason that people or the statements is what they make, though, it's just they're coming from the wrong place with it. It's not like, oh... I didn't like the way this story went, or I didn't like how the writer approached this idea. It didn't feel natural at all. All of a sudden he found out he was gay or whatever. It's, oh, I hate this because he's gay now. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
people don't know how to, like,
yeah,
like
it's
that.
People that
like
are still in the wrong mindset,
yes.
right? That's the problem, right?
Yeah. They're very ignorant, yeah, and they're just like, you know what I mean? They come off very badly, and whether or not they have hate in their heart, if they're just going to they come and try to conversate to me about that shit,
yeah. and now they have the
I'm
best
just not
platform
entertain
to put
it, bro.
Right?
Like,
they have the internet.
Whatever.
They have the internet. They have the best platform to yap
That's
about
right.
their, you know, because they can hide behind it, and not,
yeah.
you can't show your face, and it's like,
yeah.
hey, you can say whatever you want, right? That's
yeah.
what they say. That's what they're thinking, right? But you know what? They're pussies. They wouldn't say it on national television or something to somebody. That's just the way it is, right? So,
yeah, the alt-writers, like the guys that are big Trump supporters, I don't know if you also heard, speaking of Marvel movies, they mm-hmm. just hired back James Gunn, the director of Guardians of the Galaxy 1 and 2.
Okay.
They had fired him initially because these guys caused such a stink because he hated on Trump. He's like one of these guys that, like, you know, was against him and his
yeah,
politics.
Yeah.
That these guys found these old tweets that he did like several years ago where he jokingly made some, bad taste like type of jokes about pedophilia that
okay.
he made on the internet.
Okay.
They found these somewhere because, like we said earlier in the episode, once you put it out in the world on the internet, someone has a screenshot of it, it exists.
Exactly.
Since then, the guy has already apologized for these statements he made. Anyways, that shit don't matter these days, as we know. Before
yeah.
they even have a chance to look into the matter, he got fired from doing number 3, Guardians of the Galaxy. This guy was one of their biggest money makers, a success story of a director that fucking made those movies of characters no one fucking knew the Guardians of the Galaxy's big successes.
Yeah, yeah.
To the point where he had a cast members, they all signed a petition to get him back on the movie after he got fired. But the studio, because it's Disney now, owns
yeah.
Marvel,
yeah.
fired him right away because they're like, listen, we can't be associated with people that make pedophilia jokes, right?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
So,
the joke is a joke. I
right,
know, but
rightly so. I mean, they were in bad taste. They were in bad taste,
of
right?
Of course.
Anyways, but he admitted this as such, but it doesn't fucking matter these days. So they fired him. Anyways, the news just broke that they rehired him back recently. But get this, Warner Brothers, the guys across the street that own DC Comics, as soon as he fucking got fired from Guardians 3 and basically all things Marvel, Disney at that point, they hired him to do the next Suicide Squad movie.
Oh, wow, right?
So now, he is still contracted to do, write, and direct the next Suicide Squad, and then is going right into Guardians fucking 3. What a payday for this guy. You know, listen, it's he worked it cool. well. They picked him up right away as soon as he got fired. That was smart.
You know what? I didn't even know who the Guardians of the Galaxy were, man.
Right. Yeah, the talking tree and fucking raccoon. Yeah, I remember you said that. You're like, who are these guys?
Who are these guys, man? But, you know, it ended up turning out to be really good. I didn't realize how good of characters they actually played.
Yeah, those were great movies. Yeah,
they never were a comic, were they?
What's that?
Were they a comic?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, all those characters existed outside of that team originally, and then they joined the team together. Like, that iteration of the team, like that version of the team, didn't actually exist until the 2000s.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah. So, that movie is quite fairly, maybe late 90s, early 2000s, I would say, that version of the team. Because Groot was never like that. Drax was never like that character that you see in the movies. They were all kind of different, those characters. But then, that version of those characters, and the fact that they just amplified the humor with this Guardians of the Galaxy movie, is basically... Now people see some things, like people read comics nowadays and they look back and no one can think of Tony Stark Iron Man as someone other than Robert Downey Jr. now. Like, it's impossible.
I know.
Because he made such a... you know what I mean? Like, he is that character.
That's who he is now.
So in some of it, there's been times with the movies now that some of it is translated back to comics and the writers start writing the characters in the comics like the characters from the movies.
Yeah, okay.
Which some people aren't a fan of. No. But how can you not fucking when this guy's, you know, it's Robert Downey Jr., exactly. You know what I mean? Like, that's Iron Man, as far as I'm concerned.
That's his character. He's got that personality, too. And he knows how to play the role, right? If you know how to play the role, you can act, you could just blend it in with everybody. And then, see, that's the problem. He's going to get, he'll be typecasted, but you know what? That's a role to be typecasted on. If you're going to be anything... Because they're going to be always making money. Iron Man's always going to make money. You know, Tony Stark's always going to make money, regardless if it's him or if it's anybody else, right? Other than Robert Downey Jr. But now, like he said, you do it well. It's like Johnny Depp. I mean, he did the Pirates of the Caribbean. That's who he is now, you know? So,
if you want to get into that, if you want to kind of transition into somewhere,
I don't know. I just thought of that right now, but now all of a sudden, that brought up a whole new topic in my head.
You want to transition to some news now?
Well, if you want to talk about it, let's do it, because that was kind of funny, an interesting story. From what I read, I don't know if I've gotten it all the news correctly, but. From what I read, that you know, he had some. He's always had issues with his women. There, his girlfriend. She's a lot younger than him too. So
Amber Heard.
Yeah. I mean, well, she's in her 30s, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
She's hot, good-looking woman.
You're Johnny Depp.
But you these bitches be crazy, bro. She's crazy.
They're always crazy, dude.
It's Johnny Depp. Maybe he's the one that made her crazy, right?
That's what I mean. You know, that's what it is, dude. It's not like...
He's an odd guy, that guy, but women love him, right? Like,
How couldn't you, man? He's just a great character in his role. He's a great character. He's a great person, I think, in real life, if I'm not mistaken, people, the way they talk about him, right?
Sure.
So, I mean...
So anyways, the news broke.
Apparently, he's had some some assault charges previously thrown against him, allegations.
But the last couple of years, people have been shitting on him for these original allegations.
Okay, and he's gotten away with it. He's still been the face of the Pirates because, you know what, Pirates beat their women.
Yo, this is where you're wrong. They already did, like, what, five movies?
But
he lost out on the opportunity during this whole thing to do another one because of this.
No, but isn't he going to do another one? Isn't that the whole story,
Maybe now.
Yeah, because I thought they were going to do another one.
Maybe now because of these recent developments. Yeah. But prior to this, they didn't want to do another one with him because of all this shit. So basically Amber Heard said that he beat her up, like he's an abusive
boyfriend. Husband, boyfriend, whatever you want to call them.
And if anything, she was right at the height of the start of the Me Too movement.
This whole thing,
yes.
Before it even...
Kind of helped propel this.
Yeah.
Anyways, this past week...
We find out that she's got previous allegations against her about alleged stuff about her.
He's missing a piece of his finger, bro.
No, but not only that, Nico. I mean, I didn't hear... just that. I've heard that she's had...
Severed finger.
She's had actual things where she... Like, I mean, the black guy that he had at one point apparently came...
Turns out she was very abusive, and she's admitted to it.
Well,
yeah.
She had an ex-girlfriend or an ex-friend, that girlfriend that said it about it to her, if I'm not mistaken, said that she had charges against her.
Oh, I didn't know this. This I didn't hear.
Yeah,
okay,
that
okay,
I just read the other day, and it was pretty crazy. So, and I thought that's why, originally, that's why they were going to drop these charges,
this
whole controversy thing with Johnny Depp. But
yeah.
No, apparently, yeah, he's... I didn't... The whole part with the finger, too, that was just fucking nuts, bro. I mean, how do you do that? Do you get it bitten off? Do you get it, you know, cut off? Do you, what, like,
all
what
I
do
read
do?
Is that his finger was severed, one of them. Like,
you play a good pirate that way.
She admitted to being... She was abusive in the relationship. It came out, during this
She's
lawsuit.
Young, too. You know what I mean? I mean, he's probably got women throwing
sure.
himself.
It's Johnny fucking Depp,
yeah,
right?
You know,
yeah.
You know, he's been around for a
Amber
long time.
Amber Heard was
man.
Really no he one. She started in The Rum Diary with him. I don't know if you've seen that movie. That's the chick
I heard,
that was
yeah,
in
I've
that.
Seen that. I've seen it. I've heard of it. I
it's
know
an okay
100%,
movie.
Yeah. There's quite a few good movies that I haven't seen of Johnny Depp. I know he's in quite a few. I mean, he's been started off since he was a teenage heartthrob for most chicks back in the day, right?
Sure.
So they had posters. Those are when the girls had posters all over their wall of him. You remember that?
Team like, Beat.
Yeah, exactly, man. From what was the TV show there?
Yeah, the one that they did the movie of.
21 Jump Street.
Yes,
is that the one?
But they remade it. They did 21 Jump and 22 Jump Street.
Yeah,
that's the Jonah Hill movie.
But but that's what I didn't chat.
Yeah,
it
was that
was
one.
The first
yeah.
one. But that's the TV show that he was in originally.
He showed
right?
up. He did a cameo, I think, in the second film.
It just shows the way they were how good of actors they started off. Because that was a long. That was years ago. That was what. 20 years ago, 15, 20 years ago.
But listen, this is a big blow to the movement.
It is.
To the Me Too movement, this is not a good look for them right
now. Yeah, it does suck, right? I
hate to say it, though. I don't want it to be a blow to the movement for all the people coming forward and it's helping them. But,
exactly.
But this is, I am kind of glad this happened, only to say that not every case should be fucking open and shut. Look what happened. Because we don't, this whole thing, maybe it was a little bit of both of them. We don't know. But it's not all one-sided always. Like, everyone's just trying to, you know
what I mean?
Like, I'm sorry to say.
There's a lot of men that are wusses out there. And, I'll put myself out there. I might act like a tough. But when it comes down to it, I'd probably let some girl kick the shit out of me, too. Which is a problem. And, and then I probably wouldn't say anything. Because, if she was as hot as Amber Heard, I might be sticking around with her, right? Mm. But, I get what they're saying. There's a lot of guys. And obviously, we get looked at a lot differently. I don't want to get into that whole Me Too movement thing, but we also get looked at a lot differently because we're men.
Yeah.
But sometimes the men are the soft ones and the women are the crazy ones. I'm sorry, man. I know there's going to be a lot of haters saying something about it on this one, but it's just the truth, man. I'm sorry. I've had women drive me. They can drive some men crazy. I mean, dude.
Yeah.
Remember, they hold.
Vice versa,
We have the key, but they hold the key.
Sure.
They hold the lock. Bro.
Yeah, they have the power. That's what I mean. They once they know they have all the power in the relationship, right? And I don't know
You know what it is? They're just okay. I'm not saying that they're allowed to have every right. They should have every right that we have. I'm not saying
absolutely.
That,
but and that's what I mean. I don't think
we
it's
can't
a good
take
thing.
Advantage. None of us, either in, guy or girl.
Sure, no one's saying that. But I also don't think it's a good thing that this happened because it's going to hurt their movement right now because whatever, that's good for them that this is...
These people actually did have something happen to them, obviously.
But I just think it's, in a way, it's good for them just to kind of take a step back and still analyze what happened here.
Yeah, and domestic abuse
and
stuff
note
like
of this.
That. And any sort of abuse.
Yeah.
Right?
Just, you know.
Men and women.
But it hurts, man, this fucking news breaking like this for them. Like,
it
really looks bad right now.
Yeah,
and
it does.
Like,
I think that
people shit it on
too.
Him too.
It's
like,
not as
years.
Crazy on the news as you think it might be because it is a guy.
Yeah.
But a lot of the times guys don't come forward too because they're like, "Well, I'm gonna be a pussy in front of everybody else." Like, you want to say something?
I'm kind of disappointed in a way. I wish he really was a woman abuser because, it's fucking Johnny Depp. Like, at least I had that over him because even my girlfriend's in love with him. When this happened, I'm like, "Oh, look, Johnny Depp. He's not such a nice guy, is he?"
Exactly.
All of a sudden, this news broke out. I'm like, "Amber Heard's a crazy one." I'm like, "Ah, fuck."
You know what? But then it's like to the women, take a look in the mirror.
Whoa, take a step back. Alright, moving on.
I got a gold trophy from the committee for validation. Bad press during the summer over allegations. I ain't lying, my nigga, my time is money. That's why I ain't got the time for a nigga whose time is coming. A lot of niggas PR stunting like that's the movement. And I'm the only nigga still known for the music, I swear. Fuck them niggas this year, I made Forbes list, nigga. Fuck your list, everything's looking gorgeous. Without me, rap is just a bunch of orphans. But if I stayed in the shit, it's a bunch of corpses. And me and my dread nigga from New Orleans, stashing money like hoarders off multi-platinum recordings. Eating like I'm seated at Swiss Soto with Yosos. Nothing was the same, this shit for Easy and Coco. This shit for Kareem, this shit for Javon. This shit for Julius, Melly Mill. Boy, we do this shit for real. All them boys in my wheel, all them boys is my wheels. Anything happen to pop, then I got you like Uncle Phil. Weezy been on the edge, you niggas just need to chill. If anything happen to pop, he might pop a nigga for real. Coming live from the screw face, living out a suitcase. But I'm feeling good, Johnny got me pushing two plates. My weight up, I refused to wait up, I started a new race. It's funny when you think a nigga blew up after Lupe. Niggas treat me like I've been here for 10. Some niggas been here for a couple, never been here again. I'm on my King James shit, I'm trying to win here again. A young nigga trying to win here again, man, what's up?
Hey, yeah, a young nigga trying to win here again. If I like her, I just fly to the city I'm in. I got a drinking with your boy, I got him fucked up, shout it, ah, oh, yeah.